Hey guys, it's Queendija, and in today's video, I will be reacting to episode 7 and 8 of Uramichi Oniisan. So let's go ahead and get started with episode 7 in 3, 2, 1. Hold up. Okay, take 2 in 3, 2, 1, go. Alright, let's see what the hell happened today. Okay, and what? Oh, God. And she overheard! Oh, my God! I would literally hate to work at a job where you over here, yeah, I've got some plans for her, whoever, and you'd be like, oh shit, like how, oh God, oh, oh my God. BTW, I'm going to go ahead and say this now. It is 1:14 in the morning, so just in case if I yawn, just know it is, I'm tired and I need to get this done. It is just like, oh God. This week has been hell for me. I don't even want to talk about it. But yeah, that is all I'm going to say. It's just, too much. And I hate it. I hate it so much. Sometimes I wonder how in the world I was able to do so many shows in a week, and now it's like, how in the world can I do it? Because sometimes I never really have time, and it's so freaking hard. And I had, once again, I had to postpone something again, and I hated doing that because it's just very hectic, and then so many other things are coming between my personal life, and it's just like, ah, here you go. Like, trying not to be too loud for my neighbors. I'm sorry, my neighbors. Basically. It was easy. You just, you know, cut circles, I mean, well, lines, and then you just glue them together either with glue or tape. Nice shorts. Look at the kid. Oh. Oh, baby. Do you not know how to cut? Or is it... Oh, God. Oh! You want some help? Oh my god, Teddy, poor baby. Oh, Jesus Christ. Somebody please help him. Help him.
That's okay. That's okay. Daijoubu, daijoubu.
Stop, I'm What are these Danganronpa colors? Ew. Stop! Oh, Teddy!
Right?
Honestly, yes, because sometimes I wonder, where in the world did they hide this whole cast? You're so right. Live for yourself. Let's not talk about that right now. No. Kids are such a blessing. Oh, my God, guys. He's so precious. Oh my god. Time out. Time out, time out, time out. Time the fuck out. How? That's all I'm gonna say. How in the world?
Teddy. Uh-oh.
Poor baby. Right? Maybe you guys should go talk to him. I mean, yeah, he's always been preoccupied, you know, with his mind mentality and everything. He's just so, oh, damn. He's just so adorable. You want to talk about it? Yeah. Well, what exactly is wrong? Yeah. Oh my God, please tell me y'all didn't argue over this. They fought over this. No, the dick joke again. Seriously? Yeah, I mean, but you know what? The biggest thing is, like, who are you gonna stay with, though? Yeah, so that's not gonna work, unfortunately. Pop, I'm like, hold the fuck up. I want to punch you. You know how, hold on, let me say it like this. You know how some people are very cautious about letting their friends over in their personal space or their bubble or whatever, and they feel some type of way? Bruh. Right? Oh, God. Yeah. Exactly. No. There we go. Okay, so now Teddy, you go ahead, you take what he just said to the kids and run with it. There you go, baby. Go apologize to your sister. Oh, you forgot. Of course she did. Is that what's his face? Hold that. This fucking show. Oh my god. I mean, you know when the show just casts, like, some of your favorite seiyuus in together. Oh, my God. You're doing it with this show. This show is a goat, so. Once again, the target audience for this show speaks oh so much. Bruh, like, you know, the little kids probably like, oh my god, this is a really nice outfit, Uramichi Oniisan, but you know. Oh, Jesus Christ. I mean, but he looked good, though. Baby, oh my god. You know what, I can't believe I'm gonna say this, but you know what, this is just TV in general. When people, whether you were on a reality TV show, a scripted TV show, whatever type of show that you were doing and you're getting money for it, the freaking producers, the writers, whoever, hell, even the stylist, they will have you wear the most ridiculous things, but you get paid. I don't know how much, because it makes you wonder, because, like, especially with, like, reality TV show competitions, especially with one of my personal favorite reality TV show competitions, the show that I'm about to talk about, this show has been airing since almost for 33 seasons. As of right now, 33 or 34, one of the two, because I know they're either filming their 33rd second or their 34th season. And some of the challenges that they do, one, crazy enough, the outfits sometimes that they have to wear during the challenges is already hilarious as is, because there are some that are going, you know, from that time period and everything, and then there are some that are really, really funny costumes. And it makes me wonder, from these contestants and stuff, do they get paid per episode when they're on this show for however long? If somebody goes home in that first episode all the way to the point where whoever that team wins that money by the end of, I think it's like the 12 episodes. Because they're gone for about a month. But who knows? Wherever it goes, some good behind dumplings. I would one in the morning, I'm craving dumplings. Oh, yeah, it is. I mean, but yeah, but you know, some people appreciate that though. Oh God, that is karma. Karma is such a bitch sometimes. But yeah, continuing back on what I was saying, especially like, I don't know how much, like, for people who work on scripted TV shows, especially little kid shows, or even something as like Dora the Explorer, especially one types of shows for little kids where it's more of still like something like Dora the Explorer, or when I was a little kid, like Blue's Clues, Bear in the Big Blue House, almost like the educational programs for little kids. Hell, I you know, probably say that with Roly Poly Oly or PB&J Otter, because, you know, it's like that. Disney and Nickelodeon was fighting for their competitions for these dance shows, no matter what, the other day. But it makes you wonder, like, specifically, even looking at little kid shows to scripted shows for teenagers or adults, how much they get paid personally every single episode, especially with, like, the one of my personal favorite shows that I was just talking about a couple minutes ago that has, like, 30-something seasons. And some of the things that they have to do, and some of the things that they have to wear and such, when mainly the people who are doing the show, they're going out and doing their scouting and everything. and such. Because one day I want to, if I ever meet anybody from my favorite reality TV show, I just want to ask them, so how much did y'all get money for this per episode up until y'all got eliminated or something? Because the things that I have heard, like, freaking crazy. But, I mean, honestly, this was a very interesting episode, especially with Ted and his sister fighting over something. I mean, like, to me, it's like, really, are we fighting over this? But at that moment, of course, I understand why his sister was like that. And then he comes back home, and she completely forgets it because, okay, yeah, I get you, one track mind, and it's like that, because a lot of us are like that, and everything, and it's so fucking adorable, but, like, can you just imagine, like, if Tenma had to stay with Uramichi? Oh, God. Like I said, it's just like, you know when people are finally officially inviting their friends over, and at the same time, they don't really want, like, their friends or anyone close to them to get in their personal bubble? That's what it's like. And people are like, you know, they're like, I don't really feel like I'm someone over my damn house. But, and then you make up lies saying, no, my house ain't clean when it is. Or you just, you're that type of person who just doesn't want to be around people all the time, even though you are, especially wherever you work, you're around people all the time. But sometimes you just need, like, time away. Whether you are an introvert, you're an outrovert person, maybe depending on how your mood is, essentially, at the end of the day. Because some people, you know, being around people can drain the ish out of it. And you can see it all over Uramichi's face. I mean, goddamn, I felt so bad for him. Poor baby. But go ahead and pause the video and I'll see you guys in 1 second for episode 8. Okay, episode 8 in 3, 2, 1, go. Any tip? Frick it, I'll just take lip gloss then. Well, damn, do we have to be so loud? I mean, it is 1:45 in the morning, my time. Uh-huh. Like, he okay? I can't. Oh, poor baby. That. I cannot with the. Because he looks like Bernie in the background. Oh, I know that feeling, babe. Yes. Yeah, exactly, kids. Oh, God, I love this show so much. No. There are times where, once again, I can relate to this show, and then there are times where, like, yeah, I can't relate to that, bruh. Oh, God. Adulting. Remember when we were all kids and we're like, oh, I can't wait to be an adult. And then you're an adult, you're like, bruh, I want to go back. Like, I don't like this here. Oh, God. Bruh, so high. Like, sometimes I hate not having the, like, enough energy that I want to have to kind of complete, like, a whole bunch of things. And then especially when I get really, really tired, like, okay, I'm about to do a lot of things in the next few hours. I'm probably going to be up until not 4 anymore, because I'm about to do a lot of ish. I'm probably going to be up until about 7 in the morning. And I'm going to try to run on no sleep. I'm trying to get a lot of things done today because I got to postpone until Saturday and a couple other things till Saturday. because originally I was going to post one next week, but I'm like, you know what? No, I'm going to do it today. I'm going to get all done. But by the time I finish everything, I'm going to be really, really tired. And you're probably going to see it in these videos, but I got to be happy. Even though I'm going to be like, oh, what's up? But I don't think it's good to ignore him like that, you know? Hell fucking. Yes! Because I feel like that too! Yes! It is so, like, what the fuck? Well said. Well, you know, I ain't worrying about that. Well, damn. Yeah, because, like, what else did you use your money on? Hold up, bruh. Hold up. Exactly. And that's just for a one bedroom apartment? Oh, God. I mean, because, like, for where I live, it depends on it depends on how much. Oh, God. Why don't you just ask for a raise? I mean, because, you know, no offense, you're not the only one who has to pay rent. The shade, oh my God. No, he's not gonna be okay, unfortunately. Oh. I love kids so much. They're so precious. Protect the children. Oh my god. Seriously? Please, no. You are a precious cinnamon roll, but you don't need to give him money. Exactly. Oh, don't worry. It'll be resolved. It's like almost how, like, I've seen, I think for, like, almost the past month or two, I've seen, like, videos on TikTok where it shows you, like, dividing your money and separating it for, like, bills, rent, play, like, your own money for playtime or whatever, fun things, and then I think one more, I just can't remember what it is. Oh, insurance, basically, for anything. But really, that's still more in the bills section, so. Of course. God, he probably is pushing himself oh so much. Oh, oh hell nah. No, no, sir. And he's gonna lift, like, mainly with... Shit, no, she's good. Oh my god. My poor baby. Sir, you had to pay your rent first. Get that associated, and then you can go out. Oh my God, really? He a cutie though. Very. Yeah. You're not gonna get fired. No, Jesus. Oh, okay. No, thank you. Oh, Jesus. No. Oh, God. But he's not a father. What? I'm scared now. Oh my God! Oh, excuse me, I'm sorry. God, the back of my hair. Did he mean to say that, though? Oh, that's so sweet. They gonna make me cry at 2 in the morning. Oh. Huh? Exactly. We go, what? No. Yeah, but shouldn't you too? Yeah, you gotta make him a bear and a bunny bow. Exactly, you're supposed to draw a bunny and a bear. I'm dying on the inside. Like, they were... What the holy shit. Oh. So you had a pretty fucked up childhood. Honestly, that kind of reminds me, especially when it comes to children of parents who going and continuously going in the strict thing, because I've seen parents who are very strict with their parents with their kids, and certain kids have a little hard time with struggling with like older adults because they feel like they're going to be very serious like their parents and everything. And so, from what Uramichi was saying, he had a really bad upbringing with his father and everything. Because, of course, I'm guessing his father wanted him to be the best at gymnastics. And he was, but unfortunately with what happened with him, of course, because of that, his life came crashing down. And, of course, he had to have a job, which, I mean, he's getting money, but he's not getting, in my opinion, almost, like, what he deems is enough for him. Like, if he had done okay in his gymnastics and everything and been able to become this big professional athlete, like, yes, he would have been fine being financially stable and having his money and being very independent from his father and the rest of his family. But then at the same time, it seems like he would be a very cold person or an unhappy person. Like, even the way he is now, and especially with his mental ability and mental illness and shit like that he currently has and how he feels about not only people but the world in general, I think if he wasn't like that, he would have been a complete and total different person. Maybe even a happy person, you know? No. I mean, even though we, I think, okay, so we're on episode 8, so 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. We got 5 more episodes with this, but technically for me, we got 2 more weeks with the show before I'm done. No matter how many times, like, because I'll either any moment with Uramichi or any of these characters, at the end of the day, you still feel bad for them. Whatever they're going through at work, home, personal life, professional life, whatever, you feel bad for these characters, truly. Even though at the end of the day, like, I can sit here and laugh at these characters and all the ish that they're getting into, at the same time, with the shit that they have to deal with, it hits you really, really deep with this show. Because we're all dealing with that some way, shape, or form. Especially whether you are in your... You just maybe hell even got out of high school, you're going into college, you decided to not go to college and you're getting a job, you're in your mid-20s, you're in your early 20s, whatever age you are, you can be in your 30s and have, like, issues and things and everything. You can have an anxiety that you really didn't think you were going to have or anything, and you go and talk to somebody about it, and it's just hard. The world is hard, and it sucks. That is all I will really, truly say about that, but, I mean, you know, maybe one day... One day I'll probably, like, do, like, a podcast type thing where because I talked to my mom about this a couple hours ago, where I was like, yeah, I might do a video one day where I am just speaking for, like, hours, like, an hour or two between, like, recording-ish, and just be like, here, I'm just gonna post this out and see. Have, like, a little test video and be like, hey, let me see if this just reaches somebody as much as my anime stuff is and the problems that, you know, we're all facing and it's like that. But it is crazy and stuff, and how... Even though we are, like, very close to being done with this and how you can really relate to this show, I think, like, truly, everyone who did watch this during the summertime literally could relate to this show every single week. And what if they weren't feeling the certain things that Uramichi was feeling maybe about, like, week one, week two, probably the closer and closer that they got towards the end of this show, they really were like, damn, this show speaks so freaking much about adulting. There are a lot, like, and this is why I like a lot of shows with adult characters in it, because we're at a point in time, especially as a 90s kid, where sometimes, and maybe even now, especially with, like, the current generation that is growing up, there are some parents who don't really want their kids to be taught a lot of things and then everything, and because of the fact is, if parents don't teach their kids a certain amount of things, they're gonna have to experience it out in the real world and such, and all the, like, the real world issue things that you're going to see because of the fact is that the parents, like, shielded them from oh so long and such like that. This is now, like, saying that, oh, hey, you know, you're an adult and you can still have problems about this. You can still have an anxiety about this, a mental breakdown about this, this, that, and the third, and that it's okay. This is teaching even people, myself, like, at my age, it's okay to feel these feelings and have the certain ways and being upset about this, this, that, and the third. Because we're normal. We're all human. We're doing it. It's a grind day in and day out. And sometimes you just want to, like, You want to lose, and sometimes you have to get the fuck up and do everything to the best of your abilities. There are going to be some hard, like, not every day is going to be easy. There are going to be some hard effing days, and you feel like you can't win. Don't ever give up. There are days where I truly want to give up. Like, oh, God. I just want to say, fuck it. I don't want to do anything, because it is very stressful and such, and yeah, that's all I'll say. Very stressful. But now I'm like, my attitude is changing in the way I'm looking at things, and sometimes I'm like, you know what, fuck it. I gotta get this ish done. But yeah, I really personally enjoyed these two episodes this week. But other than that, guys, that was my reaction view towards episodes 7 and 8 of Uramichi Oniisan. If you guys enjoyed it, please give me a like, really helps me out. Also, subscribe to my channel and make videos every single day. Join the Marshall Squad. And of course, I will see you guys officially all next Friday for episodes 9 and 10. Bye, guys.